The Philippine Justice Department welcomes a recommendation for an executive review of the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla has revealed a joint program with the United Nations Commission on Crime Prevention and Criminal Justice. The program launched a series of talks with the Philippine government and some civil society organizations regarding the drug problem. In the discussions, it was agreed that it's time to reevaluate the country's two-decade-old anti-narcotics law.
The DOJ supports the conduct of an executive review in the light of Philippine administration's new direction to approach drug cases through the prism of public health for persons who use drugs and small-time peddlers, including persons involved in low-level drug transactions, in due recognition of the health, social, and economic factors surrounding such activities. Nevertheless, the government remains committed to go after organized and big drug groups through effective, focused, and dedicated law enforcement.
News overseas now. Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan calls for unity and solidarity after narrowly winning a historic election that extends his two-decade rule until 2028. Now, Erdogan's call comes after a divisive election, rather, that saw him beat opposition leader Kemal Kılıçdaroğlu by 4 percentage points in Turkey's first presidential runoff. Now, the election has been seen as one of the most consequential yet for Turkey, with the opposition believing it had a strong chance of unseating Erdogan, who suffered a popularity hit. Kılıçdaroğlu has conceded defeat, but calls the election the most unfair in years. He urges supporters to continue the struggle against an authoritarian government. Erdogan, meanwhile, thanked voters for again giving him the responsibility of governing and says the entire nation won. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. creates an interagency committee to address inflation and boost the Philippine economy. The body is tasked to monitor the main drivers of inflation and provide recommendations to curb price spikes and promote food security. The Interagency Committee on Inflation and Market Outlook will be headed by the National Economic and Development Authority Secretariat. Other government agencies, including the Finance and Budget Departments, are also part of the committee.
The Senate Blue Ribbon Committee will review the claims of Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin regarding sugar importation. Bersamin told senators in a probe a sugar order is not needed prior to importation. The Senate panel is investigating the legality of Sugar Order No. 6, which authorized the importation of over 400,000 metric tons of sugar. It became controversial following the entry of sugar imports in Philippine ports, despite the lack of an order.
Pinag-aaralan pa ho natin, lalong-lalo na yung mga statements ni Executive Secretary Bersamin bilang dating Chief Justice ng Pilipinas kung meron talagang basihan yung kanyang sinabi. So hindi ko pa masagot lahat yan at amin pong kinukumpile pa lahat yung testimonies at maging yung documentary evidence.
The Philippine Senate considering extending the discussions on the Maharlika Investment Fund Bill until Thursday. That's according to Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva. He says the move aims to give way to debates on possible amendments to the measure, but the Senate still hopes to approve the bill this week.
We see the relevance and the noble intention of the administration in pushing for this particular measure, but we have to do our part, no, to scrutinize and do everything we can to ensure na, for example, yung mga pension funds hindi masayang, yung mga safeguards dapat nandiyan. Tatlong buwan nang pinag-uusapan yan. If we pass it on second reading this week, we'll be able to go to third reading and pass it on third and final reading. And I heard that the House will adopt our version.
Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III, meanwhile, reminds his fellow senators to not rush the passage of the bill. He also urges them to take a second look at the bill's provisions. Two more priority measures of the Marcos administration expected to hurdle the House of Representatives this week. According to Speaker Martin Romualdez, these include the Philippine Salt Industry Development Bill, and it seeks to revive the country's dying salt industry, as the country largely imports its salt supply at present. The other measure that is expected to be approved this week is the Bureau of Immigration Modernization Bill. It aims to refresh the country's immigration law to cover battling cross-border crimes such as smuggling, illegal recruitment, and human trafficking.
Philippine lawmaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo again denies planning an alleged coup to oust House Speaker Martin Romualdez. In a recent statement, Arroyo slammed reports she had been duped by a lawmaker into believing that First Lady Liza Marcos backed the idea. She says it's the people behind the rumors who are duping the Filipino people. Arroyo asserts it is disrespectful to the First Lady and to her intelligence. She also clarifies she did not have any conversation with any politician or lawmaker to plot, support, encourage, or participate in any way in any alleged house coup. The former president also notes house coups could only be successful if they had the consent of the president.